Assalamualaikum. My name is Widi Mutakin from Expose Academy. When we do UV unwrapping in Blender, there are times when the resulting UV layout is perfectly straight like this. But on different occasions, sometimes they are tilted like this. Some people think that this is just a random behavior of Blender's UV unwrap algorithm. Well, actually, this is not a random behavior, and we can easily recreate the problem. Okay, so what is actually causing the problem then? After experimenting for some times, I found out that this UV tilting problem can happen due to two reasons. The first and the foremost reason is the dimension of the model. For example, these boxes. The edge seams assignment for both of these boxes are the same, but they have different dimensions. The first one, which is generating the correct or the straight UV layout, has a dimension of 12 units in x-axis, by 5 units in y-axis, and 6 units in z-axis. And this box, which generates crook or tilted UV layout, has a dimension of 12 units in the x-axis, just like the first box. But notice, the dimension for the y and the z-axis are identical, which is 5 units. This actually what causing the tilting problem when UV unwrapping. So essentially, if you have object with at least two axis dimensions identical or very similar in values, it can be x and y, or x and z, or y and z, or even all of them, x, y, and z, have the same or similar dimension, this will make the object to have UV tilting potential. Okay? Now you might be wondering, why am I saying that this is just a potential? Well, it is because the second reason of why UV tilting happens. The second reason is because the edge seams assignment. For example, this box has the Y and the Z axis dimension identical. It has 12 units in X axis and 5 units for both the Y and the Z axis. Basically, it has the same dimension with this box, but it has different UV seams combination. Notice if we select all of the faces, then U again to unwrap, we still get this nice perfect straight UV layout. So, as you can see, some edge seams combination can cause the UV tilting problem, while the other combination will not causing it. But in my experiments, this edge seams combination can only create the tilting problem if the first reason exists. So again, the second reason only happens if the first reason exists. Okay, now we know what causing this UV tilting problem. But what if we actually need the dimension to be similar? And, or, we need to have that certain UV seams combination which causing the UV tilting problem. How can we fix the UV tilting then? Well, there are many methods that we can use to fix the UV tilting problem. We can use the follow active quad method, or we can use more manual align method. In my Udemy course, which is Blender 3D from Zero to Hero, I actually explain a lot of these techniques in more in-depth. But in this tutorial, I'm going to show you a quick easy way to fix tilted UV layout like this. First, open the UV image editor. Make sure we are in vertex mode. Basically, we want to align these two vertices only. We can actually pick any two vertices that we like, but let's just focus on these two vertices. To align these two vertices, one common way to do this is to use the auto-align method. Make sure the two vertices are selected. Press W and then A. So basically, the W shortcut will open the weld align panel, and the A shortcut is to use the align auto in here. Okay, this method is a very common method, and most of you guys perhaps already know about this method. But the problem with this method is that both of the vertices are moved. If this is not a problem for you, then you can use this method. But right now, I want to show you an alternate method. And with this method, we can move only the selected vertex. For example, the bottom one only, or the top one only. It is up to you. Let me undo the line auto command before. So we are back with our initial vertices position. Okay, basically, we want to move and snap this vertex so it aligns with this vertex at the bottom. First, make sure the snap option in here is set to vertex and the snap target is set to closest. But do not turn on the snap mode button in here, so snapping is currently off. Okay, now we want to move this vertex horizontally. Usually, we do this by using the G shortcut and then X to constrain it to X axis. We want to use a different method now. To move this vertex horizontally, right click and drag, and try to move the vertex in horizontal direction. Then, press and release the middle mouse button. Notice Blender will detect our initial movement and then determine that we actually want to constrain to X axis. Okay? Now in this condition, hold Ctrl. This will activate temporal snapping. Move our mouse cursor on this vertex, and as you can see, the top vertex will align perfectly with the bottom vertex. I know it seems a bit hassle at first to do this, but trust me, once it is in your muscle memory, you can do this faster than having to press G and then press X or Y. Oh yes, also, you can actually do this in modeling session inside the 3D view editor. Okay, after we have these two vertices aligned perfectly, select both of them and pin them by pressing P. You can find the pin command also in the UV menu down here. But using shortcut is always faster. And I know almost all Blender users are shortcut lovers. After we have these two vertices pinned like this, next, we need to perform another UV unwrap. Now, you may already know how to UV unwrap in the 3D view editor, which is basically pressing U and then U again. In the UV image editor though, it is actually much simpler. Just press E shortcut. Now, as we can see, we have this instant straight UV island. You might be wondering by now, how can this be possible? Well, it is because we have these two vertices pinned. When Blender tries to UV unwrap the whole UV island, it cannot move these two vertices. Therefore, what is happening here, the other vertices will yield and follow these pinned vertices instead. Okay guys, I hope this short tips video can help you fix your tilted UV layout faster. If you want to learn Blender from zero and master all of the in-depth 3D skills in the shortest time possible, then you should join my new Udemy course. I have the link with discounted coupon code in the video description below. And as always, subscribe to my channel, share the video, give a thumbs up if you like the video, and give a thumbs down if you hate the video. Check out my other tutorials. Wassalamualaikum.